they get 100% guaranteed credit of 10 lakhs for the TTSs, who are agents or travel agencies, and 1 lakh for tourist guides who are licensed either by the regional or the state level authorities.
I remember last year when I worked in March 2020, and then this situation came, we thought that it will go because it's the off season coming, so it's fine. But that carry on not only in the country but throughout the world, and people have pain. So many people have lost their life. But of course, if I talk in a turn about my job, my profession, I think anything happen, anything big, scary happen in the world around, one of the most affected industry is tourism industry. And it's really gone bad from the point it started, and we have already lost more than 1.5 years, and we don't know what's going to happen ahead as well. So it's just dark. On a personal view, as we are a people who working on a label, on a down level, where we see everything, and we felt that what need to be improved and how it would happen in India. Because see, India is a country which have big aspect in term of tourism, but in that way that people are not coming, so we are not well advertised, we are not well infrastructure. The government don't have any policy, even from the last government,
yeah,
to from the Congress to BJP and all. I have really hope in this government, but personally I must say that there's nothing much happening right now in a system, so that can we say that yes, something is happening. Like example, I was just laughing when Sitaraman announced day before yesterday, in their speech, that we're going to help guide because they lost their second season, you know, and we're going to give a 1 lakh rupees. So what, man, you know, we don't need a loan, we need a work. And of course I understand there's a problem going on, there's no work, and understand I support in that point, but a government should have think about if they give a loan, how we'll give them back. You know, and I'm not asking, as a guide, we are not asking anything free. Even a one suggestion I can forward them, please, 1 lakh is nothing, but you can increase 5, but just hold to repaying a loan for the next 1 or 2 years. So once everything is get open, when we start earning and it's easy to pay.
The government of India really wanted to do anything for us, it would have been great if they would have given us loan without interest.
Yeah, without
For a certain period of time. And then after that, and that certain period of time can be determined by the fact that when tourism starts.
Mm-hmm.
Let's say the tourism, as per my experience and my understanding of how it works, I think that tourism, inbound tourism, will start in October 2021, roughly. So after that, let's say October 2022, from then onwards, October 2022, the tourist guide, the inbound tourism will start.
Uh-huh.
So maybe October 2023 onwards,
uh-huh,
they could have charged us interest.
Interest,
right?
Yeah. That's the right.
Till then, if they could have given us a loan, like they give it to the farmers. For a certain period of time under the Kisan Credit Card, it is non-chargeable.
Yeah.
A very minimal charge of 1% or something is charged.
Yeah.
That would have been really helpful. But what they have done is providing us loan at a market interest price, roughly. 8% is something which is the rate of the home loan is right now, 7.25%, right?
Mm-hmm.
So they are providing us a loan on a market interest. So how is it going to help us?
Mm-hmm.
We are already under so much pressure, monetary pressure, that we cannot take loans. So we are taking loans from friends and families and things like that, where we don't have to pay interest, right? and then when the tourism season will start, we'll try to pay them back. So this whole step looks to be a complete futile exercise.
See, till inbound not started, that till the time that foreigners not start coming, we will remain a jobless. I think they have mentioned the 5 lakh visas free. The government don't understand. If you're putting a visa, if you really want to dominate the tourism sector in a world, to just leave it that visa price and just open free visa to throughout the world, and then so many people come, then you don't need to collect the money for the visa, because there's so much money will come without that if the people are traveling, and it will reach to the person, to the person. It's not only the government, that what government want. They want to give up money to the people. They want their income to rise. So if they want to make that income rise, they have to take the responsibility. They have to make a law that can provide a, you know, the better aspect to the people actually.
See, inbound tourism, you can only give visa to the people who are coming to India, right? As of now, every single country has advisory against traveling to India, right? Now, when there is an advisory, negative advisory, traveling to India, no one will like to travel, because then their government does not cover the insurance cost, does not cover anything else, right? Now, when you are going to a foreign land, as these inbound tourists will be going to a foreign land, coming to India, they need their government's assurance. Also, they come along. India is already known for its malaria and typhoid and other things. So they make themselves covered through insurance. But when there is a negative advisory, let's say American consulate says that don't go to Kashmir, right, because there is terrorism. And if some American ventures into Kashmir and is killed, no insurance will cover that because there was an advisory. So similarly, if there is a negative advisory against traveling to India, you know, no tourists will come.
So many of my friends, even I have started some, you know, marketing job and all. The people have opened a shop to sell Kirana stuff. No, selling a milk. They have started a sweet shop because there's no way to run their house. There's no way to feed their families. The people are doing it not to die, so they're trying to save it. From the last couple of years, we are fighting against the government for what? The government who take an exam, we clear that, they give us training and programs, and now they're saying that your license will be cancelled and you have to go for another training program and you will be just a normal guide and a monument guide. We are the people who are graduate with the language and many more, and in those conditions we got selected, and still they're saying now that people will join this system who are 10th pass and 12th pass. How a person who have not knowledge,
I'm
not
saying that, knowledge of anything,
and then you putting this country in front of someone who don't know about that, and he will understand what you're saying. So what the message you sending to the world, the government, this tourism industries have to understand, which is really wrong. You won't believe, I have something to show you. This is my license. This is Sanjeev Kumar, which I got in 2014, and this is expired now. And they're renewing every year with this kind of paper. Even they can't make this kind of format anymore. They don't spend the money. And even they're taking undertaking that only I will sign your, I will give you the license if you become a part of that program, which is the government is running. So this is all hell happening, and we are really opposing this. We are really going against this, and we're not taking license. We're not giving any sign to that Janpat thing, what they're asking actually. So this is really bad actually.
about this licensing process.
Yeah,
when you have a licensing process, you have a mechanism to check the license. If I give you driving license, there is traffic police who checks your license. There is no point in having a licensing mechanism where there is no mechanism to check who is doing it right and who is not doing it right. In tourism, there is no such mechanism. So even a tout can posing. There have been many cases where touts have kind of defrauded the guests, where touts have some rape cases in Jaipur have come along. And he posed as a guide. We are pained when it says that guide raped a thousand tourists. He's not a guide. He's a tour. He's a tout. He's posing as a guide. So there is no mechanism of checking an obviously because of the corruption which is present at the monument level. You know, the person who is supposed to check your license when you enter, he takes money and he allows you in. So there is no proper mechanism. We have been requesting the Ministry of Tourism that when you give a license, this is the time of digital era, give a license with a chip. So that we enter, because we don't pay monument fees. We enter, we put our chip there and the gate opens and we don't pay for it.
And I'm sitting at home right now from the last 1.5 years. I really miss my job because I love talking, I love meeting people, I love traveling, I love food. But if you look for that in a perspective, because of course I can't do anything other than this tourism actually, because this is the job I have accepted. But personally, I would say that I don't want to send my future, like my children, to this job, because the way it's happening, the way it's treating, the way we are got manipulated, the way we got to suffer, I don't want, or not, no any father want their children to suffer. So of course, if things never change, because this job is a kind of like, you know, it's quite respectful. People comes and they ask you about the country and you really love. Even if you had done 7 days tour and you taking a new client, next day you have a same energy with this new person to tell that what India is. But do that, what I felt in this industry, my son should feel that as well. No, I don't want that, because if things not change, I would never allow my children to go into this system to get the job, because I don't want to die in a way that I'm dying slowly in this job, because I'm carrying a pain and laughing and smiling in front of the client, which I don't want my son to be followed. So if the government really want us to live, you know, smiling, real smiling, then they have to start working towards this. So I hope that the government will listen and they will come up with some ideas actually. And the people who are also in industry, I know that everybody have their own problems. Everybody have their own system, but the people who are in system sitting on a higher, if they change, the life of the lower people will change dramatically. So they need to make the policy in a right way, and they have to respect the guide, because we are for you people. We working for you, we working for the foreigners, we working for the government, we working for the country.